guys, it's Sam, and I am going to be doing mostly makeup related empties video. There are going to be some non-makeup stuff that I'll do at the end, so let's get started. I apologize for the air conditioner, but you guys know me, I am always hot, so the air conditioner has to be on because it has been hot in New York this past week. Okay, so let's get started. The first things I'm going to show you are primers. And so I've tried the Maybelline Master Prime by Face Studio Blur and Smooth. This was okay. I don't know if I would repurchase again, just because it's kind of like every other primer that I have come across that's kind of silky but more moisturizer than primer. So it's the same with this one. This is the Wet n Wild Coverall Primer. Just that, is it a moisturizer? Is it a primer? I just don't see it doing much for my face, so I wouldn't get those again. I don't know, maybe the Maybelline one. That one was kind of okay. Then we have the Porefessional. I've always wanted to try this, but really, I did not see a change in my pores, and I have really large pores, kind of like everybody else, right here and here. The one I'm using right now is very similar, and it's the NYX Pore Filler. And again, I see some filling in of the pores, but not completely, so I wouldn't get this again. Let's see, a bunch of foundations here. The first are the Sonia Kashuk Radiant Tinted Moisturizers. These are so old, I don't even think they make them anymore. I got one in beige and tan, and when I first got this, I did use these a lot, but that was before my face started breaking out and into really bad acne, cystic acne, and I needed full coverage. And I really like full coverage. I think even if I didn't have face issues, I would like full coverage. I just really like the way that it looks on my skin. And well, now it's kind of out of necessity that I need full coverage, but these are really nice if you have really great skin and you have SPF, if you want SPF and not that much coverage, these are good. But these are so old that I am forcing myself to throw these out. I'm kind of embarrassed at how old those are. Well, I'm not really embarrassed because I feel I am not an expiration date person. I feel like if it smells good and it looks good and it applies well, it's good to go in my book. But once any of those things go south, then I'm gonna throw it away. Next is another product that has there's still a lot left in here. This is the Revlon Nearly Naked Makeup Foundation. And this actually was in my declutter, and I was going to get rid of it, and I went back into that stash that I said I shouldn't go back into, but I still haven't used it. Again, with the coverage, I need full coverage, and so this doesn't give me full coverage. So I'm going to be really saying goodbye to that. I have here a couple of the Maybelline Dream Matte Mousse. I had about 5 or 6 of these that I wanted to go through, and I did it. I really like these. The only thing with them is that when you try to apply it, they go into little balls and they kind of make a mess all over you. So that's not so great, but I do like the coverage, and I would get these again. Just I wish it wasn't so, not that you could see, but I wish it wouldn't make such a mess. So I finished those two. I also finished the CoverGirl 3-in-1. Love this foundation. It's really good. It lasts a long time, and there's the color. This one was nude beige, which is a really good color. And I have a couple more of these that I have in my stash. Then for powders, I finished up the Makeup Forever Dual Matte Powder. Really like this. This is good for if you like extra coverage, which I do. And then I also finished up the Milani Multitasker Face Powder. Just a good overall face powder. This one is in light tan. And I think I would get the light. I have had this issue where of all the older makeup products that I have gotten that in my stash, it's all too dark for me, so I'm trying to get products now that actually match my skin tone. Then I finished up the Bare Minerals. This one is the sorry, Bare Minerals Foundation. You guys know what this is, but I finished that up. And I am trying this new thing where I do have a set list of makeup products that I am trying to use up, but also now I put into a drawer here all the powder and cream products that I have that I want to finish up, mostly face products, because I am just not a loose pigment person, and so I'm going to try to get rid of those. But that is probably one of the hardest makeup things to finish, because just pressed powder, loose powder and cream products, you don't really need to use a lot of, I feel like, so it's probably going to take me forever. So this drawer, I'm going to try to do it, but it's going to take me a while. Okay, let's see, a couple of nail polishes here. This is the e.l.f. nail polish. The brush is really wonky, and I'm not in love with the color, so I just decided to, it's time to let it go. Sally Hansen Hard as Nails. This one is called Royal Ridge, and if the color was like what was in the bottle, I would have kept it, but unfortunately it was not, and you need at least 4 coats for it to be even similar to a color like this. And so I'm like, no, I'm never gonna use that, so let's get rid of it. A couple of mascaras. The Maybelline Lash Sensational. So I finished this, and this is the Full Lash Bloom. And out of these two, I like this one better. This one just, this, I feel like this didn't give me any volume. It did good with separation though. This brush was pretty good, but I just feel like I like the whole thing. I want my eyelashes to curl, add volume, add length, and this one did not do it. It was actually didn't do any of those things. And then this one is not too bad. I don't think I would repurchase, just because I like other mascaras more than this from the drugstore, but this one wasn't bad at all. And then, oh, I finished up, this is the Hourglass, the sample, and you got a lot of use out of this one. This is the Mineral Veil primer, and I know how expensive this is, but I could see how people liked it. It feels really nice on the skin, but again, it's like a moisturizer to me, so I didn't see any, I don't know, I feel like I'm a really picky in some ways, where I wouldn't repurchase a lot of products. But I guess, I don't know, it's just some things not a lot of things I would repurchase, and this one isn't one of them, but it was really nice to try. I'm getting rid of this MAC Paint Pot in Soft Ochre, which is really disappointing. I didn't use a lot of it, as you can see, but I like the color, but it just never stayed on my oily lid, so that was kind of a bummer. So I am going to be getting rid of that, and then I will put that into my Back to MAC. And then this Sonia Kashuk quad in Fair and Square. This was so disappointing, because two of these colors, these two barely show. These two just so powdery and hard to work with that I'm going to get rid of it. But if it did work, in theory it works, but in real life it just was a fail. And then I'm checking the mirror just to make sure that I don't have, I'm trying this NYX Liquid Suede in Cherry Skies, and I'm always afraid that I'm having it on my teeth, because that's happened a couple of times. Then I have, this is the NYX, I had depotted the NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk, and when I first started out doing YouTube, NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk was all the rage, as the 120 color palettes were all the rage, and you needed something like this to make the colors pop. But this doesn't work on my oily lids, and that's something through trial and error, you just learn to find what works for you and what doesn't, and that unfortunately doesn't. But it was fun to play with at the beginning, but I don't wear like, you know, crazy 120 palette colors anymore. So that was the last product that I want to share with you. So a lot of things I never finished up that are going in here, which is kind of a bummer, but I'm getting to the point where I am trying to just get down to the products that I am going to be using and I like, and throughout, like, it's like most of my life I'm trying to do that with clothes and jewelry and shoes, just things that I can pick out of my makeup drawer or my closet and I like it and I'm gonna wear it. And just if I'm not gonna use it, I just give it away or throw it away. So that is where I am at with my life. I just want it to be simple and not feel overwhelmed with everything. So that was my most, oh, you know what, I was gonna say goodbye, but I do have a few products that I want to share with you that I would repurchase. And where is the other thing here? Okay, I'm not sure where that thing went, which is kind of a bummer because I really wanted to share with you. Oh boy. Let me pause you and I'll be right back. Okay, I found it. It fell on the floor. The thing I was talking about was this Bliss Multifaceted All-in-One Anti-Aging Clay Mask. And this was a sample that I got from, I think it was a Sephora coupon kind of thing. I really like this. When it came out of the package, I thought it was just going to be really smooth, but it was actually grainy. And so I felt like it was exfoliating my skin, and then it set, so it went to work on other ways on my face, and I just felt really like it was nice to use, and it also made my face feel good afterwards. So I would definitely get this again. And then some L'Occitane products that I would get, it's from the Almond line, and I really like this line. I was surprised because I don't like almond flavored products. I don't like the paste and the cookie, and you know that smell is not just, it's not something that I like, but this, they did a really good job. It smells fresh, but it also does smell a little bit like almond, but more fresh than anything. And the oil, I used it during the winter with the body lotion that I was using at the time, and I swear this made my skin feel so soft. I would get compliments on my skin, and it just made it feel really soft, especially during those cold winter months. And then this is the Milk Concentrate, and this is if you don't like heavy moisturizers that leave you feeling greasy and take forever to dry, this is not one of them. This is very liquidy, but it also is effective. So I would get any of these almond products. I got it from the Sephora L'Occitane. It was like a gift set, but I really like the almond ones that I had chosen from it, and because I had separated some L'Occitane products from the set and gave it to my family, but I chose the almond products to keep, and I really liked it. The hand cream is also nice. It's a little bit thick, but those two products that I just mentioned are wonderful. And now this is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So that's where I am at with my makeup life and my clothes life and shoes life. I am just trying to just narrow it down to the things that I love. And yeah, I hope you guys, I wasn't sure where I was going with that, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know what other stuff you would like to see from me. I'm still acting like a crazy person in regards to my upcoming cruise, where I think I need to get so much more things than I do need. Let me know what your cruise essentials are, and I hope you guys are doing well. I'll talk to you soon. Bye!